been a long wait for the sequel to Blizzard's wildly popular real-time strategy game. Now that the beta testing phase has been opened up to a select few, we're getting a more concrete sense of how things are changing in StarCraft II. This time we're going to focus on the Protoss units and how they've changed from the Brood War days to now. Let's start with the probes, the lowliest of Protoss units. These little guys are responsible for your base building and resource collecting. They function largely the same in StarCraft II as they did in the original, although with a nice graphical overhaul. And one of the great things about probes, when compared to the build units of the Zerg and the Terrans, is their ability to lay down a building without tying up your probe until it's finished. Since you're not going to be able to resource your opponent to death, once you've made a gateway, it's time to pump out some Zealots. These were one of the basic offensive units back in the first StarCraft, capable of tearing through enemy forces with their side blades. They function the same way in the sequel, though they can now be upgraded with a sprint ability. Remember the Dragoons from StarCraft? They were the bulky, spider-like electro ball shooting ground units that were basically good at everything. Yeah, well, they're sorta gone. Instead, Protoss players will be taking control of the more fragile, but more mobile Stalker units. Stalkers can be upgraded with a blink ability that allows them to teleport short distances, making them perfect for sneak attacks. High Templars were one of the deadlier units in the first game. Incapable of standard attacks, their Psionic Storm ability can tear through entire armies of weaker units and really badly damage the bulkier ones. They're back again in StarCraft II, and can still dish out Psionic Storms, though they've unfortunately lost the Hallucinate ability. Their shadowy counterparts, the Dark Templar, are also quite similar to the original manifestation, being cloaked melee units. A few Dark Templar can tear through anything in a few swipes, making them potent stealth attackers or strong defenders. Now back in the day, two High Templar could be merged into an Archon, while two Dark Templar could be merged into a Dark Archon. In the StarCraft II beta, you can merge any combination of two Templar, High or Dark, and you get your standard Archon. They're still big, fiery, and cool, but they don't seem to have the same impact that they did in StarCraft I. Though it's a beta, so of course everything could still change. For a while there, it looked like they weren't gonna make it, but carriers have returned and bring with them swarms of tiny interceptors. This time around, however, new carriers come preloaded with 4 interceptors and don't require any research to bump the cap up to 8. The Reaver in StarCraft I was the main tool of mass destruction for Protoss players. These giant mechanical slugs built and launched explosive scarabs and were capable of dealing big damage from a distance. In StarCraft II, you get the Colossus. This is a brand new unit that essentially takes the place of the Reaver in the original's tech tree. Whereas the Reaver was slow and cumbersome, the Colossus is quick and able to even walk up cliffs. Even a small squad of them can cause some serious laser-related headaches. In the original game, to get a Reaver anywhere near your opponent in under a month, you needed a shuttle. This little flying unit was your standard pick-up and drop-off flyer, and it has been replaced by the Warp Prism in StarCraft II. The Warp Prism does the same thing, but is also able to deploy and broadcast a small psi field, allowing players to warp in units from a gateway. Be sure to warp in something worthwhile though, or there could be problems. The Protoss Arbiter provided players with a way to warp in units almost completely undetected. They couldn't fight well, but their cloaking field and recall ability made them a potent ally. In StarCraft II, the Arbiter has been replaced by the Mothership, an enormous glowing spacecraft. The Mothership shares the Arbiter's cloaking field and comes equipped with a new Vortex ability that can disable units in a small area for a little while. It's also a capable attacker, but its real value is in the Mass Recall ability, which can instantly transport many, many more units than even the Arbiter could to the Mothership's location, allowing you to deliver a punishing strike on your opponent. The Protoss possess many other tools and tricks that are brand new in StarCraft II, and we haven't even looked at the Zerg race yet, so clearly there's a lot more to see. Stay tuned to IGN.com for more updates.